than Jesus. Thank God that yesterday's gone.
Good morning, Pastor Larry here. It is Wednesday, August 17th. And our verse today comes from Matthew chapter 21, verse 21. The Bible says this: Jesus answered and said unto them, Verily I say unto you, if ye have faith and doubt not, ye shall not only do this which is done to the fig tree, but also, if ye shall say unto this mountain, Be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, it shall be done. And all things whatsoever ye shall ask in prayer, believing, ye shall receive. You know, tonight's Wednesday. Tonight will be Wednesday night, our midweek prayer service. And we've really been trying to put our focus on actually praying and spending time in prayer. And I want to encourage you to be here tonight. We're going to break into groups and take sections of our prayer list that we've just been accumulating and pray over them as groups and try and get just some fervency in our prayer and some just really trying to get a hold of the Lord. And, you know, Jesus makes a powerful statement here. Now, mind you, he had just finished cursing this fig tree. And they were walking by a fig tree. He went to get some fruit from it, but it was a fruitless fig tree. It had nothing, just leaves. And Jesus said, from henceforth, this tree shall no longer bring forth fruit. And the tree withered away. And the disciples were amazed at this. You know, and I can't help but, and he said, you know, he said this to them. And I can't help but wonder if, as Jesus said, if you ask whatsoever you shall ask in prayer, believing you shall receive. If they started thinking, well, man, I wonder if I could like curse this tree over here. If I could, you know, say this and this would happen. The problem was, you know, what were they praying for? Who were they praying for? Who were they praying to? You know, we can ask God, and I've said this before in our church and stuff. Sometimes we get this mindset that God's like a genie in the bottle. You know, we get into a problem or a situation or we really, really want something. And so we'll say, Lord, I really need this, you know. Lord, you know, this would be the best thing for my life and all these things. And we start to ask. And while we can believe very much that God will answer those things, but the problem is we're not understanding truly what is going on here. You see, the thing about Jesus and God the Father is Jesus knew him. They were close. They are close. Jesus knew him quite well. You know, when my kids were little, they would ask me to do things that they knew their daddy could do. They would ask me, Daddy, would you open this? Or Daddy, can you fix this? Or Daddy, and they would ask me, and I would do it. I would do. They trusted in what they had seen and what they believed, and that caused them to ask without doubting whether or not I would do it. And that's because they knew me, you know. And what's really cool is now that they're older, they're adults, they know what I can do. And because they know what I can do, oftentimes they'll wonder, well, what can he do? Hey, Dad, my son will call me, hey, Dad, can you do this? And because he was in hopes that I can, and knowing that if I can, that I will, that I'll come. If it's going to help his life, and my daughters will call and say, Daddy, have you ever done this? And knowing that if it's going to make their life better, knowing that if it's going to help them to be more productive and to be just have a better life, then I'm going to do it. And that doesn't mean they can say, hey, Daddy, I really want this car, or Daddy, I really want this in my house or whatever, and I'll give them whatever they want. See, sometimes what they want isn't really going to make their lives better. It's not going to really help them. And sometimes what they want isn't really within my power to do. But if it's within my power and it's something that I can do, it's going to help them, then, man, all they have to do is ask. And they know that about me. But, man, what about our Heavenly Father? He's all-powerful. There's nothing he cannot do. There's nothing he can't do. And there's nothing he won't do for his children. But do we really believe that? Do we really believe there's nothing he won't do for his children? Most times, and this isn't just about asking for the things we want. Most times, the things that I want, God knows I don't really need in my life. It's not going to make my life more productive for his benefit, for my benefit, or for his benefit. But see, there are things that I need in my life. And the reason that I don't often get those things is, one, I either won't ask or I will ask, but I'm not really asking it for the right reason or the right way. And so I asked this question this morning. I read this passage. Do I really believe this? You know, Pastor John Horton, my good friend, Pastor John Horton, said this years ago in a message. He said, prayer only works if that's what you believe. And that's a powerful statement. Prayer only works if that's what you believe. We want to pray tonight. I want to pray, but I want you to come tonight with a heart ready to reach out to God, knowing he's your Heavenly Father, knowing that of what he has done in your life and what he can do in your life if we simply ask him. But man, it also is going to take the fact that we've got to be close to him. We've got to be close. We've got to know him. We got to know, you know what? I'm asking this, but is this really what God wants in my life? Is this going to help me serve him? Is this going to help me serve him? Is this going to help others see him? Those are some great questions to ask before I really start to expect for God to answer. You know, I can believe that I'm going to get what I want all the time, but what I really need to believe is that God loves me and that God's going to care for me, and that if I'm really asking something for his glory, for the benefit of his kingdom, that he's going to ask it. If I ask anything in his name, if I ask anything and I believe, I'll receive it. Man, Faith Baptist Church, come tonight. Let's come believing that our Heavenly Father wants to do something in our lives. And then let's yield to him and let him do it. Amen. God bless you. I hope you have a great day. I hope to see you tonight. Have a great day. God bless.